Give me move. Yeah. So Python is going to be an open source programming language, and Python is an interpreted, object-oriented, high-level programming. So the word open source is known to everyone, right? So it is free of cost, and you can download in from the net itself for the free of cost. When it comes to high-level programming, right? So the way we are writing the Python program itself is very easy when compared to the other programming language, which makes very comfortable to the programmers. That's a big advantage of Python. It is very simple in syntax wise and execution wise, and it is readability, and it reduces the cost of programming maintenance. No need to write thousands of lines. Even you can complete it within a few lines of code, you can achieve it through the Python, right? So Python has a lot of modules and packages which encourage the program modularity and code use. Like if you want any kind of technology, like for example, if you want to be a data analytics, right, you have a lot of Python modules which will support data science. And if you want to be a machine learning engineer, for that also we have a lot of modules, Python modules, which will support to make you as a Python machine learning engineer. Even for artificial intelligence, and even for in testing domain, we have a lot of frameworks, and internal frameworks also will be developed by the big giants like Cisco, Juniper. They will also have their own framework in Python only, right? So it is good to start with Python. It won't leave you in the. It will save you in all the perspective. It's my personal experience. If you have a Python knowledge, you will have a great future. That's what my experience. I want to say. I want to convey also. So when it comes to the evolution of Python, so it starts with 1990s, you can say it like 1990s, it starts with the Python version 1, and in 2000 we have Python version 2, and from 2010 onwards we have Python 3 version, and as of today, Python 3.9 is the latest version, and we need to know it like the latest version will support only on Windows 10. Earlier version, with respect of any Windows, it will work, but when it comes to the Python 3.9, which is the recent one, which will support only for the Python Windows 10 version, right? And we have two versions, we will talk about in later, Python 2 and Python 3. So it doesn't mean that everyone will work on Python 3 version only. It's not like that. Some of the companies which still working on Python 2 version also. But as of today, Python 2.7 is the last version, and from 2020 onwards, there is no development from 2.7 version, right? And in my personal opinion, if you are going to be a beginner, it will be good to start with Python 3 version, better with the 3.9.
Okay.
Right. Okay. And when it comes to why we are here, that's a question, right? That's very important. And we are here to know about Python. And I want to share about the demand of Python in all the technologies. So recently, we have in the last 2 years, even I'm in the IT industry for the 12 years. Recently, I'm seeing like a lot of growth in sudden growth. Even I can say like sudden growth in technologies. Like all of a sudden, we are having AWS into the picture, Azure into the picture, and Google Cloud, GCP into the picture, and Kubernetes, Docker. All those things are there. And again, we are having a JSON file. A lot of technologies are growing up, right? So all the technologies in the recent 2 years will support or its demand. Sarim, can you mute yourself here?
Okay.
Yeah, thanks. So in the last recent 2 years, right, we have a lot of growth in technologies, and all the growth in technology wise will have the Python role. Even if you want to be a data analysis, yes, there is a lot of modules for Python. Every technology is correlating to the Python. So if you are good in Python, or if you know Python, you will have your own demand. That is what the guaranteed. If you are in a Python site, so you have a Python will have the role in data analysis, and web development is a good role, and DevOps. And even in DevOps, now it moved to DevSecOps also. In all those things, we will have the writing the script task called writing the script, automating the script. And even if you are a web developer, you have a development job, everything will be there. And in the machine learning, yes. Because why I'm saying this, like all the technologies, we have a Python support modules. So that is a very big role. What I'm saying is, so that is a very big importance, which will give it is kind of a gateway. It is a kind of gateway for all the technology. If you know Python, yes, that is a key towards every technology. Right, even for a networking side, yes, I'm an automation engineer working for Cisco as a client. So Cisco is having a hell lot of frameworks, which is developed only in Python. Even if you go to Juniper, even if you go to any telecom-based companies like Rakuten, AT&T, and all the Mavenir, all the telecom companies or networking-based companies, Python is they are using the Python as a web development as well as for the automation script, right? You have a real demand for the Python for the towards the technology. I'm saying towards the core technology. So in Comet, so we are going to cover these 20 modules, even I can say like modules, and one is the introduction part, and the Python installation, how the Python installation is going to be there, and number, operators, list. So under the list, we have list slicing and list methods will be there, and tuple sets, dictionary, dictionary slicing, and dictionary methods, string. Under the string, we will have the regular expression concepts and string methods, loopings, your for loop, while loop, and how the Python is interesting, how the Python is varied from other programming languages. And even we have the main topics called functions, oops, and error handling, and file handling, and JSON handling. Like basically now with respect to the technology, right, it is good to know about the JSON and YAML file. So here we are covering the JSON. If time permits, we will cover YAML file also. And one more thing, like modules and package. And as I told, Python has a big support of modules. You will have a lot of modules which is already developed. Just we need to know how to use those modules, and that will give the exposure towards the technology. That's it. If you are if you want to be a data science, yes, we have a 10 set of. No need to go for a 10 set of modules. Only 5 set of modules. If you know about the 5 set of modules, you will can enter easily enter into the data science. If you know how to automate some test cases kind of thing, or the robot framework knowledge, and it is it is again another key towards any technology or any big company, you can win the interview point of view also if you know Python, and it is very easy to learn as well. Even you don't need any big set of programming background or degree also. All you know is like basic operations, basic mathematical knowledge, and basic, very, very basic programming knowledge itself is enough to jump into the Python. This is a very big plus for Python as well. Right. So when it comes to the installation and documentation, we are going to see in the upcoming slides. So it is an open source, as I told, it's an open source programming language. And you can download it in program.org and go to the download sites and get the recent version of the Python. So here it is shows, right? So as of yesterday, 3.9.2 is the latest version. You can download either a zip file or a exe file and just double click on it. And you will see this is the installation page. Just click on the install now and just do it like a normal exe file. So once that is done, right, you can see this idle mode. Right, you can see this is idle mode. This is where many people will use some other idle thing. But to start with, this is good to start with from the scratch. Right, so once your installation is done, you can see this window. You can, from your start window, you can get this. And just what I'm doing is like I'm just printing hello world under the code. That's it. Right, so this is a simple program from the Python point of view, like just you are printing the hello, that's it. And this is executing from the IDLE, right? So So similarly, I want to save this file from, I want to save this program. So how I will do it? Go to the file mode. You have the file option, right? So go to the file mode and open a file. This is how it will open. So type again the same print hello world and go to the run prompt. Run module is there and you can press F5 or go to the run prompt and give the run module, or else from your keyboard press the F5. You will, the down second picture will show the idle, right? So again from the file you are able to execute the hello world. So this is a very, very basic thing where we can start with the Python. That's it. Go to this site, download this exe file, install it, and open the IDLE model, and you are good to go with the practice. Good to practice with the Python. So print from the shell and print from the file. Right. And next, so before executing this run module, right? So we have saved the file. So how we have saved the file? It is the extension of the Python file is the .py file. So how the execution has happened? So now we are able to, now we have seen that the hello world, right? So how it is executed, right? So every .py file is a source code. So which is nothing but a, this is the one, print hello world. This file is a source code. So what is internally, what is happening is like every source code will be turned into the .pysig module, right? which is nothing but a bytecode operation, and from there it will be executed as a Python virtual machine. That is an, everything is the internal, but we need to know what is happening in the backend also. How it is the execution is happening from the .py file, how I'm seeing the output, right? So internally it is converted to the bytecode. Bytecode is nothing but every programming language we have some code, bytecode, string code, and many things out there. So bytecode, the advantage of using the bytecode is like it won't interact directly to the machine. So it will be in the middle of your machine and the user, right? So that is why the execution of Python will be higher when compared to the other programming language. The reason for this is bytecode operation, right? And when it comes to next one is obvious, right? So like, so where can I read if I want to? This is open source, and your software also is a free one, and you can download it also. How, from where I can learn it? You have a lot of documents, but official documents is also coming from the python.org. Instead of download, click on the documentation and go to the Python document, right? And you will have this picture. You can see this option. So this is the this is where under this tutorial, and if you want to be a beginner, like, so you can click on the tutorial. From there, you can learn it one by one. So here 3.8.8. This is what I have installed right now because it is a stable one. You can vary according to the left side. You can see, right? So the 3.10, 3.9, or 3.8. Those are all the stable things. So the 3.10 is in development stage and 3.9 and 8 in the stable. So I have chosen the 3.8.8 version. So this is how, where we can learn the tutorial as well. When it comes to the Python, this is a very important or interesting part. So what is the advantage of Python? It is readable. Why I am saying this is readable in the sense, see, when we are going for any programming, let's say you are typing 100 lines of 200 lines of program, right? So indentation is plays a very, very role, very, very important role when it comes to the readability. You cannot write a program as a text book, right? So when it comes to the readability, Python is making the programmer to make the indentation as a mandatory, right? Indentation is mandatory in the Python, which will help us or which will make the program as a readable by default. There won't be any confusion in reading the Python code, because indentation is mandatory. If you are violating the indentation, it will throw an error. It won't allow you to write the program as you want, first. And second one, it is very easy to learn. To be frank, yes, it is very easy to learn. That is why I jumped into Python, because I'm not from the Python background, right? So it helps. Now I'm into the Python. You can think of it. Now I'm into Python. Python is saving my career. Even I can say that. It is very easy to learn because the syntax or the program or everything is straight away. There won't be any confusion, right? And it's a cross-platform. That is a very important feature of Python, which I'm seeing. Like, for example, what is a cross-platform in the sense? Let's say you are writing a code in Windows platform. You have saved your .py file in your Windows system. You can transfer that .py file to any other OS. Means you can copy a .py file from the Windows to the OS version. From there also you can execute. Without any interruption, it will execute as it is, provided Python is installed in that PC. You can take the same .py file or Python file to a Mac OS. Without any interruption, it will execute. That is a very big advantage of Python. And that is why all the companies are preferring this Python programming language. This is also one of the reasons. And you have a lot of standard libraries, which is developed and which is already integrated along with the Python itself. If you are downloading with the latest version, as soon as you are moving one version to another version, you will have a lot of modules, new modules will be included as per the demand in the market, right? The only thing is you need to explore on that module, that's it. Then you will become a expert in that particular area and technology as well, and you will have your own demand on it. Everything, as well as your career wise, your package wise, everything. Just the thing is, this open source, we need to learn, that's it. We need to explore. And it's an open source library and large standard, as I told, a lot of modules are there. And it supports exception handling in the sense like kind of error handling is very good in the Python. And if you are writing a program with good error handling, it won't trouble you to the troubleshooting. While it comes to the programming, right, troubleshooting is very, very important, because if you do any mistake in somewhere else without doing the proper error mechanism, right, it is very hard to debug to the code. Whereas in comes to the Python, right, we are having a great support called try except concept. Under that, we will have a good exception handling mechanism as well as advanced feature. Yes, obviously advanced, because the companies, you can list out what all the companies are using the Python. Obviously it is Cisco and Red Hat, Juniper, they are the giant in the networking technologies, and Mavenir, Rakuten, 5G, 3G, 4G, 5G technologies, in all the technology, G's technology, I can straight away, can all the frameworks which they are using is Python only. Very rare they are using Java, right? And Python will have, if you want to explore on any new technology, it is good to know about Python, that's it. And it's a high level language. It is it's in a high level language. Obviously it is free, and it's automatic memory management. It is again a very big plus of Python. Why? Because let's say I'm using some variables, what will happen if I'm not using those variables in other programming language? The problem which we will face is like a memory consumption of that variable, even though I'm not using it. But whereas in, when it comes to the Python, right, if I'm referring that particular variable until my program is closed, yes, still that memory will be managed. If I'm not using that, automatically it will be moved to the garbage collector. So memory management is automatic in Python. We no need to worry about that also. Whereas in other programming language, for example, C, yes, we will deliberately work for the memory management, whether I'm using that particular variable efficiently or not, whether it is consuming the memory or not. So those kind of headaches will be avoided in the automatic memory management of Python, right? And as I told in the beginning, right, we have two versions, Python 2 and Python 3. So what is the difference between Python 2 and Python 3? And just I want to tell you, like, still there are some companies which they are working in the latest version of Python 2, which is nothing but Python 2.7. But what I know is, like, after 2020, there is no more release for Python 2. The last release for Python 2 is Python 2.7. But still some companies are using the Python 2.7. Yes, obviously they are using. Just I want to give this as a note. What I want to say is, like, don't deny on Python 2, but start with Python. Yes, have a good, like, get some hands-on, basic hands-on on Python 2 also is good too for your career. Right. So just I want to show this, like, what's the difference between Python 2 and 3. Like, under the print statement, we are earlier we used to print that as under double quotes, and here it is changed as a brace, right? And if I want to do some division operation, 3/2, right? So here we will have only the integer number. There won't be any floating number, right? In Python 2, whereas in comes to Python 3.8, we have 1.5. We have the exact answer which is coming in the float point. That is the change. And earlier, like every variable types will be, we made it as a type, as a what to say, like to indicate what type of data type we will have type. Now, this in Python 3, they made every type of variables as a class, under the class, whether it is the integer or list, dictionary or set, tuple, everything they made under a class only, right? This is a major difference. And beyond that, module support, library support is also will have a major role. Python 3 version will have a major module supports when compared to 2. Yes. Like I want to show like how the memory is handled here. So this picture will help you to, let's say, so I will give you the just. That's it. So simply to print any string, this is how we are going to see. So when it comes to the management, right? So what you can do is like go to the new file. Print, give the code. Hello Python, save it. So it is saved. Go to run, press the F5.
We can't see the screen on which you are typing the code.
Okay. How about now?
It's visible now.
Yes. So what I told is like, just go to the file, get a new file, you type. So similarly, you will get the new this kind of file you will see, right? So just give the print, go to the run the module, give the run. That's it. You will have this kind of output here. This is the ideal. You will have the output here only. And this is your file. Now you can save it. So this is the difference. You cannot save it whenever whatever you are typing here, right? You cannot save it. So once your ideal is closed, everything will be closed. You want to save in a file. So this is how we will do. You got it right? Yes. Yeah. So coming to the management side, right? So memory, how the memory is managed. Let's say you can see basic operations of 22 plus 20. So without variable, yes, I'm able to see. I'm able to get the output, 20 into 2. Yes, all the basic operations I can do. But if I want to assign it into a variable, right? So I need some values. I want to assign some values to a variable, yes. So here, what is happening exactly? So this is the picture I want to tell you, like that variable X is 20 is the box, right? So this is the box. Under that box, inside that box, we have the value called 20, and that X is pointed to the box. That's it. That is how we need to take it. And I want to tell you about what is ID. So this is an some number, we are getting some number, right? So this is the number which is assigned for this box. That's it. Right. And suppose after this X is equal to Y, and I'm taking the Y and assigning assigning the X to the Y. So Y also will hold same number, right? So ID of Y, you can see id of x and id of y will be same. So coming to the picture, so this picture is very hope you will be get the clarity, like both x and y is pointing the same number or same box, so that is why you are getting the same id. You got it right. Let's say so x also is holding the value 20, y also is getting the value 20, and both of them are say pointing the same box, that is why your object id is same. So let's say I'm changing the value of x plus 1. Now what is the value of x? It is changed. Now I'm checking. Now it got changed, right? How about y? Still it is pointing the same. So here the reference of x is getting towards some other number, not to the 20, but still y represents the 20, so that is why you are getting the same id. Let's say now I'm coming back to the 20, right? So I'm getting the, again it is pointing to the same 20, so it will come to this picture. You got it right. This is how the memory is allocated or handled in Python. This is a very big advantage of Python. And even if you can check it, like ID of Y. Yes, it is true. Right? And this is a very simple example of memory management, how the Python is handling the values and variables. Other than that, nothing else. And we have coming to the Python data type, right? So these six data types are there. If you are, these are all the very basic for Python. List, dictionary, string, set, tuple, number. Like everything, majority of the thing will come under list, dictionary, and string. Like if you are good in list, handling the first three data types, you are good in Python. So people will take, you will be selected, to be frank. So all the interview questions, whatever the questions are on Python, it will come under a list, dictionary, and string. And I'm not saying no need to concentrate on sets and tuples. It will be rarely used, to be frank, right? So we will see about some basic operations on list. First of all, what is list? Right. Let's say, and this is list, that's it. Under the square bracket, you can make a list, that's it. So how you need to sense this is how I'm saying this as a list. So for that, we have an inbuilt Python inbuilt function type. So it will tell you what type of variable it is. So it is saying it is a list. It is an empty list. Okay, so here, let's say I want to give some input. We have a lot of history for the list, or a lot of content for demo purpose, and straight away I'm giving the operations to what I'm trying to do now. But when in class, right, so it will be in detail. I'm giving another string, one string. Red, green. If you need to, one more, for one time. Right, so this is the item number one. This is in technical programming language, right? So it is, we used to call this as item one. This is an item two. So the difference is, like, we how we are going to differentiate the item one and item two, in the sense we will give the comma. That's it. So again, to test this, just press F arrow and go to the point, and the same content will be typed here. Else you can type like this, type off. Yep. That's it. Again, it is a list. This is with content. Right. So I want to access this. So how you like? Yes. So what it is? It is taking the first item, second item, third. Let's say I'm going to try. So it is not having anything. So that is why it is throwing an index error, right? It is not having any index. It starts with 0 and ends with 4. Since I'm trying to access 5th index, it is throwing an index error. You got it right? Since I'm accessing the index which is not in the list, it is throwing straight away. It is throwing an index error, straight away error. Right, this is very big advantage of Python. It is telling that you are accessing the index which is not in the list, right? So this is the error mechanism. It straight away says that list index out of range. We are trying to access the index which is not present in the list. So this is an accessing, right? Let's say I want to see only the last element. And before that, we will go to the picture. So how this needs to be observed, like red will under index 0, and from 0 till 4 it will go. When it comes to the negative side, you can see like always -1 will have the last one. So it will be in the reverse mode. So -1, -2, -3, -4, -5. Let's see that also. -1. You can see the last one is getting printed, right? So till here, -5. And again, it will throw an index error, which is not present in the. This is how the list, and this is how we are accessing the list. So when it comes to the nested list, the second picture will be the picture and how it is represented. Let's see how this also will be covered. Again, I'm having the list. Yay. Come on. So this is a nested list. That is the list. You got it right. This is the list. What is nested list? In the sense, you will have one more list. That's it. List under the list is a nested list, and based on the index, you can access the content. And one more thing, even though I'm doing the mistake here, it is throwing a correct mechanism, error mechanism. You see, I did a double quotes here, right? Double comma here, and it's throw straight away. So it is a syntax error, and it is an index error, right? And for this example, this picture will show that index 0, 1 and 2, and 2 will have, I'm not using the full format form of the list, I'm just type only the C. So under this 2, right, index 2, we'll have another list. This is a nested list. So under this, we have another index 0, 1, 2, 2. Under that, we have another list. So list, another list, under this, another list. This is called a nested list. So now this also, we can learn, it will be used in companies like Cisco, like if I want to execute some show commands and all, right? So those things, and by passing the show command and all, this will be very helpful. Nested list. And coming to another important topic called the Python, function is very, very important, and this is how we will declare a function. Like, def function name, your argument, pass. That's it. Your function is defined here, right? So the syntax for this the function is your def and name, and your if you are going to pass any arguments, you have to pass it here. And what are the operations, the function body, what are the operations you're supposed to do, you can put it here, and the return value of that particular function. And here the return is not a mandatory part, by default it is none, whereas in other programming language, right, so return is mandatory, without return it won't work, whereas in Python by default it is none. And if you want to use the return, yes, you are supposed to use, if not it will allow you to work, it won't throw any error, right? Another thing is like, let's say, this function name, you have a variable called name and job, and you have to supposed to close it with a colon, print. And print the same, whatever you are receiving in the argument, print it. Right, function, I'm taking my name and I'm passing this to string. And these two are like, this is throwing some error, right? So why it is like, what are the function arguments I'm passing, right? So it is like, if I do any mistake also, right? So it will be like, it will be throwing some type error, as how many positional is supposed to be taken and the arguments, and how much we have passed. So these kind of things we need to handle properly. And one more thing, like let's say x comma y, right? See, like we have two types of arguments, like five types of, and out of which the four first three is very 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 important, as I said, right? So here I'm defining a function called add, and I'm passing the variable called x and y, right? So I'm just printing, and just I'm calling the function with the variables. So this is the example for required argument, where x will hold the 10 and y will hold the 12, right? This we can, it will take in the same order. If we want to change the order, I will go with the keyword argument. This is nothing, simply you can take this as a just I'm taking this as a, now it got changed, right? So I'm able to control which value needs to go to which variable, right? From the positional argument, I'm able to change it to the keyword argument. And let's say if you are having n number of values, I don't have any idea. Right now in this example, you have shown only 10 and 12, right? So right now I don't know how many values I will get. Sometimes I will get 1, 11, 12, or whatever it is. So how, if I'm getting n number of outputs, what I will do? So this variable length positional arguments will help us to handle those inputs also, if you don't have any idea about what kind of input you are going to receive. You got it, right? So what is default argument in the sense, if I don't have any idea what I'm going to pass here? So what is getting printed is 12 and 10, right? So if I'm not giving any value for y, because I don't know what is the value of for y, right? Here we are, if I'm not knowing any value for this y, right, this default value as 1 will be taken. You can see, if I know the value for the y, yes, I can get the 10. If I don't have any value, or I don't know what is the value for the y, since you're giving the value, default value for y as 1, this will be taken into the picture. So which is getting priority? If you pass the value, that is the priority. If you're not passing the value, your default value gets the priority, right? And this is what about a function. We can learn a lot step by step in pictorial wise, and we can, in the sessions, we can know, in the classes, we can know one by one. And one more thing, built-in functions. We are having a lot of built-in functions which is supported in the Python programming language, which is not, I'm not saying like not available, which is majority of the built-in functions supported is with the Python programming only, right? So we have sum and max, min is there. Yes, map, max is there, minimum is there. Let's say max of 1, 2. Min, yes, what is the minimum? This is the, these are the, I'm not saying like this is the only program language which is with the built-in language, built-in function, but whereas when it comes to the Python, very easy and lot of built-in options supported. You can see we have another range function. If you give a total value of y, right, so it will give a range, it will give a number from the 0 to 5. Let's say you got it right. This range function will give us, let's say, if I want to give a value, yes. So that is the difference, right? If I'm not giving any start value, this 11 will be taken as the end value, let's say. But by default, it is starting from the 0. But I want to control the start value also. How I will control? I am going to control it like I am giving the start index, no, end index. So 1 to 10. So these are all the built-in functions. Yes, going forward, yes, in our class, we will see like how the range things will be utilized. Len is there. And yes, more coming to the module. Yes, this is very, very important. Even I can say, like, as I told from the beginning, right? So module support for Python is, you will have a hell lot of modules. So only exploring to the modules alone will help you to explore on the technology, right? We will have the OS operating system modules, regular special modules, and PXpect. PXpect will help us to remote connection, right? And when it comes to the data science and machine learning and those parts, we have a TensorFlow modules, NumPy modules, KeyPy modules. So, and which I displayed, what are the modules which I displayed are mandatory to know about modules. But I'm not saying this is the only module which is present. We have a lot of modules to explore. Yes. Fine, I think I have completed the very, very basic part of the Python. So we can have a question and answer going right now. Journey, can we unmute the people?
Yes, sir, actually they can unmute themselves and
ask their questions. Yes. If you have any questions, please, I'm ready to discuss with you people. If there is any, if you people want any career change or think of thing, right? So I can suggest Python will help you to achieve that, to be frank. If any of your administrator background people are there, yes, this Python will help a lot. Before that, I want to give you one simple example, like in my office, like we have an XML query. I don't know how many of you are know about it. We have an XML query, 2000 to 3000 entries. We have 3000 XML queries is there. So earlier what those people were doing, right? So they will have 5 to 10 people and each people will handle 500 queries and they will do the manual change in the query and then they will do the operation. So how this that was converted, right? So by writing the simple program within 20 to 30 minutes, by writing some script manipulation towards the XML query, within 10 to 15 minutes, we were able to change the 300 to 3000 queries within 10 minutes. You got it right, the efficient of programming or scripting of the Python. Simple 10 to 15 lines of program is saving hours of time. It is very helpful for us to make more potential towards the IT industry. To showcase ourselves, Python is the right platform.
I have one question.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Because right now I'm working in a system, IAM in Windows.
Okay.
So I need to change my career because I need to change my career in cloud computing.
Okay.
So it's helpful for the cloud computing also in this feature because right now
I'm yes, also. For now, yes. To be frank, yes. See, like everything is not going to be manual operations, right?
Yeah.
See, when it comes to thing, most of the industry, in my experience, they will try to do the automation, right? Because they are going to have a lot of things to do. For that, doing everything on manual part is a burden for them. As I told in the earlier, right? They are having 3,000 queries, and to be frank, before that script. They are spending 3 to 4 days of time to change that query to the correct one. They are supposed to modify it. They are doing it manual. Obviously, when it comes to manual, right, it is very open to manual error. Am I right?
Yes.
Yes. So when it comes to the Python programming, right, yes, we can do the automation. Not automation, it's a simple script which will read all the queries and it will do all the manipulations. And it will give the correct one. Even if you do mistake also, it will be corrected in quick sort of time. Let's say you are doing mistake. Without doing mistake, people will do mistake. Even though if you do mistake, you can compare. If you do mistake in manual, if you do mistake in scripting, which one is easily correctable? It's automation, right? Script, we can do the change quickly.
It's correct.
Correct, right? If you do a manual mistake, it is very, very difficult to narrow down where you have done which query you have did the mistake.
So
you have 300, not 300. I have 3,000 queries.
Okay.
Four people, or if someone is doing some mistake, so it is very hard to narrow down. It is a hectic one. This scripting, I'm not saying Python scripting. I'm saying scripting will help us to work very easy. Within half an hour, I'm able to change the 3000 queries to the correct queries. I did mistake, but I changed through the script. And again, within 1 hour, I'm able to deliver the correct queries. I'm not emphasizing, I'm telling you the comfort zone of the programming of Python, to be frank, Python. Even again, I'm saying I'm not from the Python background, but I'm here for Python for more than 6 years. It is helping me a lot, to be frank, to survive in the IT industry. Only because of Python, yes, I'm here. You can close your eyes straight away. You can jump into the Python. Yes, if you want to have a domain change, yes, cloud is a good platform. And along with cloud plus Python, yes, you will have the demanded profile.
Okay, thank you. And I don't have that background knowledge, because background any program knowledge. So is it easy?
No, sir. See, this is the correct way. If you don't have any programming knowledge or programming background, no need to worry. Python is the right program. Python is the right way to jump in.
Okay, thank you.
Even you, at minimum, you need to know the arithmetic operation. You know the arithmetic operation, right? That is more than
enough. There's no, I don't have idea. That arithmetic operation.
But the question is very correct. If you want to have the career change, yes, you have chosen the correct platform, cloud. And along with that, Python, yes, you will have the demand. To be frank, getting profile for Python, people are struggling.
And how long take time, because this because if I join the course, how long take time? That course time is 1 month duration?
Yes, I think it's 1 month. 6 years is the plan.
Okay.
Oh. And it will go like it will be, we can discuss if you want the real career change. Yes, we can discuss. That's not a problem.
Because I need to really career change, so that's the reason I asked this question. Because I need to, because
yes, yeah, I can understand from the question itself. I can understand. Yes, we can.
Because what happened,
give a big thumbs up for the Python.
Yeah, in IIM also, what happened now, my company is moved to automation. So we are also struggling, yeah. Because so that's the reason we also need to change the job chain. So we are also looking, so in my team members also. Okay. So that's the reason I'm also thinking, so Python and cloud computing is very in future. So that's the reason I will join this course.
That is a wise decision, to be frank. I'm not emphasizing anything. That is a wise decision, actually.
Okay.
One question. This is Satya.
Yes.
Like you, in your course, like to what extent you can cover OS and sys modules?
What extent in the sense, like the plan is like from the basic to the, we have three levels, basic okay. to intermittent and to the expert level. So what is my current focus is basic to the intermittent level.
Okay. So the reason I'm asking is like if we have some a little bit of a programming background,
okay.
So it may be a little easier to go to the intermittent level and get more in-depth information on those areas. That's why.
Yes, our primary focus is from the basic to the intermittent level.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, thanks a lot.
Hi. Hello.
Yeah. Hi.
Yeah. My name is.
Yeah,
my name is Jude J. You said by the name J. So I'm sorry, I came in late and I actually forgot about the time. So I just have a few questions from my side. I'm calling from the United States here. Okay. So I know very much well from my experience that Python is very, very important. When it comes to automation, it is very, very important. And recently I've been going through some interviews because I'm actually a solution architect. And I could see that it is very, very important. They keep asking you about these things.
Yes.
And so for me, I don't have any form of IT background before I move into solution architect. I've done the course. I have my certification, but I feel that I still need some level of Python. Correct. To actually make me better in terms of automation. Most of the questions I really have has been answered. So, but I don't know if I can get like the recording, so I can go through all the things you talked about from the beginning of the demo class. I don't know if it's possible.
Could you please come again? I'm not getting your question.
No, I don't know if it will be possible for me to get the recording of this section because
you can you can check with Janani. They will be the coordinator. They can share it with you once in a while.
All right. Thank you so much.
Yes. And you have chosen the correct platform. I think Cloud plus Python will have their own value, own market value.
Okay.
Hey, hi, this is Deepak here.
Deepak, yeah, hi.
Hi. So I just want to know, like I'm from a testing background.
I'm from testing.
Great. That's the reason I wanted to have a quick question to you. So if I have to move on to an automation tester, say with Selenium. The major of the platform is with Selenium with Java platform.
Yes.
How does Python plays a very vital role into automation when it comes to Selenium? I just wanted to have a rough knowledge on it, and how you help it move on to automation testing.
To be frank, I'm not that much good in Selenium with Python.
Okay.
My domain, I'm from a testing, I was into the networking and data comm as well as the data center. And the majority of the client is Juniper and client. They are having their own framework.
Okay.
They are having their own framework, and all the frameworks are in, now they moved to Python.
Okay.
So, basic Python will have its own value, even if it is forget about Selenium or a framework or a testing so and so. If you are jumping into the Python, yes, it will have its own value. You can map it, learn the basic thing, and you can map it to the Selenium.
Okay. Because I'm totally into core of manual testing now.
Yes.
So I have about 5.5 years of experience into manual. But now, for the last 2.5 years, everyone has moved into automation testing.
Correct.
So I just wanted to upgrade myself into automation. That's the reason.
I can suggest is you can jump into the all the basic topics of the Python, and along with that, you can learn any open source framework,
okay.
Like robot framework.
Okay.
That is open source. Python is of open source, and plus your robot framework with Python knowledge will let you to the automation world. These two combination will take you to the automation world.
Yeah, because there's a problem in it where I don't have any programming knowledge prior to that. This is what I'm lagging into.
No problem. That's what I'm right from that from the beginning. That is what I'm saying. You no need to have any programming background.
Okay.
A basic additional operation or arithmetic operation, that is more than enough.
Okay.
Right. This session, that is what my primary focus. People who don't have any basic knowledge of programming, that is what my target, to be frank.
Okay.
That is what those people are my target. And end of this session, I will make you to comfortable zone towards you can tell I know Python. That is what my target, to be frank. Because I'm not from the background, from the Python background, I'm the right away, I'm the sample for this. I'm in 4 years, not more than, I think around 5 years, I'm into the automation field.
Okay, sounds great. We'll have a separate discussion, I think. I'll check with Janani and the team.
Obviously. Yes, I'm ready to help you.
Definitely, thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot, yeah.
Sorry, ma'am, your voice is, I think, I'm not hearing you.
This is Revati.
Revati, yes, hi, Revati.
I'm doing PhD now.
PhD,
if you're going to take up to intermediate, if you're going to take up to intermediate level now, sir.
Yes.
Whether it is useful to do the coding, sir, for my research work, sir?
Yes, ma'am. It is up to the demand, what kind of work or what kind of task your people are doing. It depends on that also, right? With this, you can do. But when it comes to a PhD and all, right, you need to explore a lot many things on the module side.
Okay.
You got it right. So once you're completing this session, right, you will be very comfortable in handling the modules. Once you're comfortable with handling the modules, yes, obviously it will be reflected in your research study. So may I know in which domain you're doing the PhD?
I'm learning
in IO. No, I'm not able to order that.
Thanks.
Sorry, madam, your voice was dropping.
Internet of Things.
Okay, IoT.
Yeah.
Yes, obviously. Obviously, Python will have the support. I think Python is the major requirement for this, I think.
Yeah, of course, sir.
Okay, yes. It will help, yes. If it is IoT, yes, obviously it will help. Python will help.
Okay, thanks. Thank you so much, sir.
Yes. So anything else?
Hi, Ayyappan here.
Yeah, hi.
Hi. I'm from the networking background, actually.
Yeah.
And to hear you also from the same background.
Yes.
So, and I'm taking care of data center also.
Oh,
so
okay,
in the networking, how the Python would be helped? Nowadays, actually, everybody is moving to the script. I do understand. I mean, even a lot of the networking devices, they are taking remotely through the script itself.
That's it.
And executing the configurations through the script.
Correct. Okay.
So in that scenario, we have never tested so far actually in our environment.
Uh-huh.
So I want to understand more how it would be helpful on this.
Obviously, how the companies are working, that we need to understand. Let's say for a Cisco, they will have their own framework, right?
Yeah.
So right away, you can, if you are in the internet, right? So you can open a tab and you can type a framework name called PyATS. PyATS.
PyAES, huh?
ATS. PyATS. Automation test solution or system.
Okay. Okay.
Right? So that is an open source framework, which recently in after 2017 end or 2018 earlier, they have made that as an open source framework. You can explore on it also. The earlier, before that, it's a confidential framework for Cisco. You can explore on that, how the Python is used.
Okay.
That is a 100% stable framework, which is used for Python, which is used for automation.
Oh, okay. Basically, we are from the Juniper platform. All
Cisco.
Our networking devices are in Juniper.
You are from Juniper, right?
Yeah, Juniper platform. Yes.
Yes. Everything is in like even many telecom companies, they are adapting that PyATS framework towards automation since it became an open source.
Okay. So this course will help on that. Am I correct?
No, sir. This is from framework level. We don't have any plan. We need to discuss with the management. Like if the people are there, then we can discuss on that also. But right now, this session is for from the scratch to the intermediate level. That is what the primary
is. If I'm going through this class, will it be helpful for me?
Obviously, right.
Okay.
See, if you are comfortable in handling the functions, the modules and packages, and that is a very basic requirement for the framework handling. Even not only on the PyATS, even you can take it as a robot framework that is very, from the beginning, it is open source, Python framework, which is used for in all way, for even for a telecom, even for datacom, even for web development, the robot framework will be used for automation. Even to handle those things, these basic to intermediate modules will be helpful. Your regular expression, basically, let's say you are executing some command in routers, right? You are supposed to execute the command from the script, and you have to validate the output of the script, right? Through the script.
Yes.
So for that, obviously, yes, you need a module knowledge, which is nothing but your regular expression, right? And your framework knowledge, and you have to know about the logging module. Logging module will be very according to the framework and according to the company also. So for those things to understand, right, these basic to intermediate level program will definitely will help.
Oh, okay. That's good. Thank you.
Yes, thanks.
Hi, this is Saranan from Chennai.
Yeah, hi.
I have a little bit doubt in this. I'm currently working in Wipro Technology, serving in the notice field now. I'm moving to transfer domain to cloud now.
Okay, right now and you're into?
Now the tech support.
Okay.
And tech support. And next is planning for the cloud. So it is helpful for Python main thing.
Obviously, yes. You can see from the last few people's discussion, right? Someone from US, right? He went to the interview, and even though he cleared he is having the certification, and he feels that Python, adding Python will be a added value. Yes, obviously. I will tell you one thing, like Python won't let you alone in the IT field. Any other questions?
Yeah, voice is breaking. Sorry, sir.
Sorry. That's what I told, right? So, learning Python won't let you alone in the IT field.
Okay.
And
okay.
That I can say it 200%.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Because the last 6 months back, I was interviewing, taking the interview for the 40 profiles for the 2 weeks, and only two profiles got shortlisted, only because of Python. The demand is for 30 members we need to take, and out of 40, 30 is the requirement, only two is shortlisted, only because of Python. I'm not emphasizing myself, that is the real demand.
Okay. My friend and my junior also is working in cloud architect and senior developer. So okay. Both are saying that need to learn of Python, then it's used for your cloud.
Yes.
They both are saying same words also. So that's why I discussed.
Yes. Those are all the
thank you.
Real words.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
It is possible to learn in 2 months because my notice period is going to end in 2 months also.
I will try my level best. Even I can refer you to my company also. No problem.
Okay.
Until you are done with the cloud.
Okay, sure. Thank. I am trying on some cloud also.
Fine.
Thank you.
Nice talking to you all. Weekend. Yes. And thanks a lot for your time, and thanks a lot for your interest. So good to see you in Python classes, right?
Okay, sure.
So can I have the feedback quickly?
Yeah, sure. You will get the feedback. When you're going to start the classes?
I think it is on 10th, I think. Jani, can you confirm?
Yes, sir. Actually, it's on 10th March.
Okay. March is good?
Yes.
Yes, correct.
Weekends or weekdays, like how the classes are going to be?
Classes are actually going to be only on weekdays. That's on from Monday to Friday, and the time is 9:15 to 10:50 p.m. IST, Indian Standard Time.
Okay.
And the batch starts from 10th March.
Great. So it was a quick session. Thanks for your time, man. It was a very quick session, and we had much of information from you. So hopefully, we get a detailed notes or detailed whatever teaching you are going to be. It might be a detailed one, and we can have a good knowledge about you, and we can have a very good interaction session on the classes.
Yes, obviously. Yes.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Thank you. That was good session. Thank you.
Can we end the session?
Thank you.
How is it?